nose wheel doors, door, we have many remembrance of all the people that have helped us XL426 here over the years, and are no longer with us. So we have some guests here today. We'll perhaps talk about that a bit further. There's some people that have been involved with the Trust over the years, so they sadly no longer with us, but have made big contributions to the Trust, and we'll actually talk about them once we've unveiled the plaque. I'd like to talk with some of the relatives here of Charlotte and David Bissett, Alex Skinner, relatives of Norman Skinner, of course. Colin King and Sam, obviously a remembrance of Jackie. Worked with us for many years here at the aircraft, Sue Lawrence as well, Matt Lawrence, of course, chief engineer. There's myself, Kevin, and my wife Sarah Packard, and Steve, there's Williams, Sue Williams, if you remember some days. What we're going to do, we're going to ask Shah. She would unveil the plaque on the aircraft, and we'll have a look, and then we'll actually relate a few things about the aircraft. So, wherever Charlotte is, if you'd like to pull the curtain, I hope it works. So, in remembrance of yes, thank you very much, that's very nice. Stannard and Les Williams. Now, all of those people have made early contributions in Vulcans and in particular XL426. So I think probably it's right to start with both Norman and Pauline Skinner. Now, Norman and Pauline were involved right from the outset of XL426 here at Southend. Back in 1989, the aircraft had been sitting here on the tarmac for sort of 3-4 years. And the original owner, the guy that brought the aircraft in, had great plans to get the aircraft flying again. They didn't come through everything, and I think it's a bit upset. Threatening to chop up the aircraft. Suddenly he reappeared and put out an appeal for help, and a number of us, some of which of us are indeed here today, and that included Norman and Pauline. We went up locally and formed the old Vulcan Memorial Flight Supporters Club. Trips off the tongue nicely, that one. And jointly we managed to save the aircraft. Now, Norman was our first, and I think it's chairman, and I think Norman probably was in membership secretary at that time. And, those of us on our seat, Jim's here, Con, some of the early crew. Now, Norman was a character, there's no doubt about it. Very tenacious. He was very stubborn. I think we probably all fell out with him a bit over the time. But he was a smashing guy, and he was really dedicated to this aircraft, as indeed was Pauline. Now, sadly, they both left us earlier this year. Somewhat surprisingly, in Pauline's case,
and Norman had been ill for a while, but they also died. So within a month of each other, we lost them. Due to the COVID situation, sadly, we could not remember them at the time, even though we were looking at them. And I think the plan on their departure would have been to bring them down here in their final tour around the aircraft on the way to their service, but it's sadly couldn't happen. But much missed and much loved by all of us here. Coming down the list, Steve Barnes. Now, Steve, we lost a few years ago. Steve was our treasurer and a member of the engineering team. A man with a wicked sense of humour.
It's not the way the plane should go.
Then next we have Tony Hollandby. Now Tony was a member of the trust and the engineering team a long, long time ago. And I think, in my mind, most remembered for playing Father Christmas at our Christmas socials. I certainly wouldn't want to just sat on his knee. He was a smashing guy, another guy with a great sense of humour. Ken Hyde, an AEO on Vulcan, a friend of the Trust, I believe a past AEO on this one, and right, King. Jackie, of course, come in here. Great stalwarts, Trust. Come in, Jackie. Jackie were always here at all the events, organising the catering from our social events, and along with Colin, looking out, looking after the stock. Days when we used to visit air shows and things like that. So, much missed. Next on the list is Ern. I think he's probably responsible for almost single-handedly painting the vault on two occasions. He was quite high up. Dennis Marrier. Dennis was another Trust member. I think the common point with all these people, they all had great senses of humour. Of course, you had to if you were working with Norman. The only way to get through it. Dennis was a smashing blow. I think my memory of him particularly was when he went on a visit to see episode 7 or 1 in 10. We were worried about when people would find him. But he'd already wagged his way into the crew room, and he's in the, was in the crew room. And the next one, of course, was my dad, Dom. Dom Packard. The game was a member of the Trust, committee for many years. He generally helped out with engineering stuff and events, so I won't dwell on that, but again, obviously missed. Alan, it's a squadron leader and painter. Alan, from the Vulcan Island, he's got a lot of sorts of aircraft, of course. Posts of the Trust, but he's a supporter, and also running the South End timeline website, and Nick's a great supporter. Nick fought through quite a lot of adversity because he had some illnesses from a very young age, and was always in and out of hospital. But he's a good supporter of the Trust, and a very funny guy. And sadly we lost him a year or two ago now, so very, very suddenly and unexpected. So we move on now to Rod Sannard. Now, Rod and Pat were another people involved in the very early stages of the Vulcan, right from the beginning here. And they used to jointly look after the engine size and so various other things. And Rod, another man with a sense of humour, very, very funny man. So, yeah, we, Mr. Rod. Finally on the list is Les Williams. Now, Les was absolutely instrumental, along with his son Steve, who's here today, in the early days of XL426 here at South. Now, for those of you that may remember the old engineering building over on the far side of the airport, which is now buried under the car park, and also where the aircraft used to stand on the far side on the concrete sort of apron that we built. Well, that was masterminded by Steve and Les, really. With help from other members of the team, you know, laid a whole concrete pad that the Vulcan used to stand on. And also Steve and Les were always interested in looking after our engineering building over there and all things engineering. So yeah, another really nice guy, Les. And I'm sure, you know, those of us as we do, for all the people there, and I'm personally, I'm glad to say that I knew every one of those people. And, yeah, they all miss sadly, but I think you think about them all with a smile. Yeah.